Now, we have had an insane 72 hours, especially over the past weekend and even at the time of this recording, about the insanity known as PAL World. Things have been going rather, let's say, pretty good for the actual developers of that game, because they have now set to 5 million copies sold on Steam alone just for this game, and even hitting a peak of over a million concurrent players. So I'm sure you would think to yourself, wow, that's amazing, and any developer has found a niche that is not being satiated by other major developers or publishers. They've created a video game, it is now being successful because it is offering a product that people actually want. What else could go wrong? I mean, there's no way there would be rampant amounts of jealousy, insane accusations, and everything else in the game developer world happening on Twitter now, would there? It's exactly that. It's literally exactly that. People are going insane for this game. In fact, Gene Park, gotta love the guy, he coined it PAL World Derangement Syndrome. So I stole that. I plagiarized that one, Gene. It's gonna be a good video! And you see, the reason why I made that joke about taking the title for this video from Gene Park is very simple. There have been major accusations of everything from the developers of PAL World using AI, which you now have to disclose whether or not you've used AI in your game, to Valve, which really just kind of debunks that entire thing. The fact that the CEO was talking about using ChatGPT and previous things, but every CEO has actually done that, so I don't really understand this. And now the major allegations that PAL World has been basically just stealing content and stealing assets and things like that, and just making an asset flip from Pokemon. Even though if you've played the game, you would see there's more Elden Ring and Breath of the Wild in there. And I've only played the game for a few minutes, and even I caught that, but hey. So let's do what we always do best. Let's go on Twitter and see what's actually going on and which developers are truly salty about this entire thing, because baby, it's a whole other ball game. Now, Eric Covington posted this recently on Twitter, saying to accidentally, quote unquote, create a complex model mesh with so near exact proportions, it's practically impossible to repeat that improbability throughout your roster. Doesn't pass the sniff test through PAL World. The thing is, Eric, the funniest thing about all of this is that you are taking the most basic things set up for anybody. Oh, I didn't know that you couldn't do wolves anymore. Oh my God, lizards? Lizards, they don't pass the sniff test? Why is it that every single developer, in fact, here's the funnier part about all of this. You see, Eric used to work for Blizzard and PlayStation. Why are developers all of a sudden getting up in their feelings about the fact that somebody went ahead and copied or had the same style of artwork? Really, it boggles the mind, because Blizzard has been known to literally copy every other type of either genre or game and then provide it as, hey, look, we did it ourselves. I could just look at Overwatch and Team Fortress 2. And you know what the best part about it is, too? I can just continue with Overwatch as well. The fact that Widowmaker is actually from a AI. That's right. Her character model, even her outfit, is one-to-one from a AI. But we're gonna avoid that one! We're gonna avoid that one, right, my boy? Yeah, look, it's... I don't understand this. Every game developer, every piece of art nowadays has some sort of thing that they're copying from or getting ideas from, and that's perfectly fine. There's nothing wrong with that. But to sit here and to lambast a company just because they decided to take a model or they try to do something similar or they have some similarities between other games really isn't the road to go down. Everybody has done this. Everybody is going to do this. So to sit here and say, like, oh, it doesn't pass the sniff test. Who are you? You are not the arbiter of what should be in the artwork of video games. You are literally an ex-dev. You are sitting here doing nothing and helping no one progress their actual art form. Instead, you're just complaining about a video game that you thought you should have worked on, but didn't. That theme continues throughout the video. T. Hallams says, I am the exact opposite of a Nintendo stan, or aka Arc / Wildcard stan, but seeing PAL World make tens of millions of dollars off of the most blatantly creatively bankrupt, poorly put together asset flip game is so depressing. Their entire company strategy seems to be theft. But he continues, there's more. It isn't even just a stolen or quote-unquote borrowed content either. The game is comprised of the UE5 default assets and barely functional animations. The entire thing just reeks of quote, pump this game out and make some quick millions before it dies off. He still keeps going. This is gonna get good. I don't like fault anyone for playing it, obviously. Well, that just negates your entire argument altogether, because we'll get to that. The onus is on the studio, but man, I can't imagine anything more deeply depressing for industry / prospective game devs than this. Why pour your heart and soul into something when you could just steal and win? The tirade, of course, continues. I'm not even some IP purist or anything. Many of the world's games started with extreme, quote, inspiration from existing games, but they ruled and succeeded because they took that and did something with it, tried something new, poured some additional soul into it. There is nothing here. And you know what? This entire thing right here just goes to show that so many people live in their own fucking world that do not understand what actual consumers want. There is a gap in the market that Nintendo is clearly leaving and letting sit by while doing nothing to satiate that market. Here come the PAL World devs, and they said, hold on, there's Breath of the Wild, there's Elden Ring, there's Pokemon, there's Fortnite, there's Ark, there's all these games that we can pull from. There's even Valheim that we can say, hey, look, here are these mechanics and here are these ideas. Why don't we figure some way of putting all of these things together so that way provides the actual person who wants to play a game like this all the things that they want, because nobody else is fucking doing this. The thing you want them to do is the exact same thing that they are fucking doing, and you're angry about it. How does this make any fucking sense whatsoever? It's really the most ridiculous thing. The only reason you're angry about it is because of the fact that somebody else didn't do it before them, or the fact that they made some really odd comments, or the other game that they made didn't do well or was left by the dust. It's an early access game. Everybody knows the risk of an early access game. The difference is, though, the PAL World devs finally figured something out and are sitting here saying, we need to satiate this market. Here's how we're gonna do it. Here's the way it's gonna be done. Who says they're not putting their heart and soul into this? Because literally, you can look at any other anime or any other game or any other sort of media and realize, wow, this copied this and this copied that and that copied that, whether they put their own twist on it or not. That's the thing people don't understand. This isn't some like moral high ground that you can take about anything. Developers literally pull ideas from other developers, and then they use those ideas and they'll twist it into whatever way they want, or they'll add to it and do things like that. But nobody calls them out then. All of a sudden, PAL World does it, and now we have a problem. Acerola says, PAL World's overwhelming success is the first step in the normalization of generative AI slop games, which is really, really depressing. 10 years ago, an asset flip game like this would have been relentlessly ridiculed, lol. I love the fact that people are sitting here claiming that PAL World is using AI and it is a slop kind of game. This is what people don't truly understand why PAL World is taking off. If it uses AI, fine. If it's a slop game, fine. But the thing is, it is satiating a market that has not been touched, that people have not looked at, that companies choose to fucking ignore consistently. And that is why it is successful. But you know what? It continues for you, and it gets even worse for you, my boy. FYI, there are no rules or regulations with AI. There is no law requiring its use be divulged. It is entirely possible to use AI and then hide it well enough that no one would ever know, and that is a future rapidly approaching. Get community noted, fuck boy. This is false. Steam requires games to disclose when they contain AI generated content. You came, you saw, you lied, you got exposed. That is one of the best things to see right up front with everybody directly going on. But you know what? My boy thought he did something. He thought he was him. The developers are not idiotic. Saying it's AI would kill the marketing of the game. I'm gonna shed some light on you, all right? I'm gonna fix what you're failing to realize. You see, Acerola used to work at Ben Studio and at Intel. They were a graphics artist. I wonder why they're so upset about the possibility of AI. Boy, I wonder why. The thing is this, I'm gonna give you a hot tip and a hot take. People, ready for this? Regular gamers, regular consumers of products do not care if the game has AI or not. Oh no. You see, the thing is, you live in a deranged world where you think you are the most important person. You have the what's called main character syndrome. Let's fix that for you right now. You are a graphics artist. If you cannot keep up and you cannot use AI properly to make your art better or provide artwork for people that want to buy your art in the first place, you are going to fall behind and you are going to be devoured by it. Because what AI is going to do is allow other people who do not have the talent that you have to then provide themselves with the ability to make the artwork that they want to make, to use in whatever process they want to use. You've got to step your game up. You got to start using AI as a proper tool. I use AI in my tools for editing, for video content creation. I use it for making my thumbnails. I use it for helping me edit. I use it for catching things that I missed. It is an actual tool that can be used. The difference is I'm not sitting here saying, oh, AI is going to destroy everything and it's going to be the worst thing ever. Yes, there have to be changes to how AI is used and it has to be disclosed, which is why Valve is doing those specific things. But to make these baseless allegations with no evidence whatsoever truly is the real shitty part about your behavior. But remember, everybody, it always gets worse. Derek Bittner says PalWorld's success is proof, everyone, that despite protestations, most people will cave and use an AI product because of some loophole. Quote unquote, it's fun. It doesn't feel like AI, etc. It'll be a sad day when this happens on a wide scale for other creative endeavors, books, music, art. It sucks. And you know what? I don't have to say anything about this because friend of the channel, my boy, my man, Gene motherfucking Park had to reply and say this. Yeah, I'm sorry, but you are speaking too decoratively on something that's only speculation at best at this point. Have you actually played the game? Ladies and gentlemen, can we please play RTU Exposed.mp4? Thank you very much.
Exposed, 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 exposed.
You're exposed. You see, as someone who's only put in a few minutes into that game, I can already tell there's going to be something that's really going to be hitting with a lot of people that really want this kind of style. Mixing other different genres, putting them together, and then applying them to so many other people truly is something that is really missing in the market. And indie devs are going to use whatever tools they have in order to make those games because it's not about what you, the developer, wants. See, that's the thing. People don't understand this. Game developers don't get this. It's not about what you want. It's about what the customer wants. There's a movie that you should definitely watch, I think, if you're a developer watching this video. Hi. There's a movie called Joe Dirt. And in that movie, Joe Dirt finds an Indian man who's selling fireworks. And what happens is Joe Dirt walks up to that Indian man saying, hey, you got any fireworks for me? The Indian guy goes, yeah, I got snakes and sparklers. Joe Dirt says, why do you only have snakes and sparklers? The Indian man says, well, it's what I like. And Joe Dirt says, no, you see, it's not about what you like. It's about what the customer likes. And I think that's the real problem with all of this. Developers think that it's about them and they have the main character syndrome when they're not realizing it's about what the actual customer wants in their video game. And how those developers make those games to get to that customer is irrelevant as long as the customer enjoys the end product. And that is what everybody is missing. Del Walker says, my gut is telling me PalWorld was made nefariously. I just have no proof, just dev intuition. No accusations until proof, but let me make this accusation first thing. Let's do that. But there's some hidden malfeasance here, Watson. I can sense it. You know what I can sense? You're a fucking idiot. That's what I can sense. You are a senior artist at Naughty Dog. Boy, I wonder what game just came out right before PalWorld and was trying to be hailed as this like amazing title to be released, and then all of a sudden a $30 indie game from a nobody studio shows up and says, you know what, I'm gonna rock your shit. I wonder why the senior artist at Naughty Dog is this fucking upset about PalWorld. It couldn't be the fact that the game they worked on after remaking the game for a remake they shouldn't have remade in the first place comes out and gets its back completely blown out by a possible asset flip. That's a Pokemon game with Elden Ring, Zelda, Fortnite, and just Valheim all together. You worked for years to do that. These guys show up and said, you know what? I hope you like second place. clown. Helion Weiss is supporting and glorifying plagiarism because, quote, it tells a massive company to do better is not the heroic flex you think it is. No, Helion, it literally is. There's not a heroic flex. People are saying, hey, get your shit together and do better because you're getting your shit kicked in by these guys. And we want you to do better and give us the product you're supposed to give us. Instead, you give us garbage like this. Yeah. Now that's what you give us, and we're not going to take it anymore. That's great. That's fantastic. It is a heroic flex. It's great because it is pro-consumer in every way. That big company will remain untouched. Fine. Whatever. Let them. And the affected ones by this mass glorification of plagiarism will be actual creatives instead. You know what? You're a pussy. You know why? Because you went ahead and blocked who can go ahead and reply to your actual tweet, but you still kept going because we know you're a fucking pussy. But then he continues saying people really just want any excuse to feel good in their support for plagiarism, because the more it's justified, the more they can keep devaluing art of any sort. We'll see where this kind of behavior, attitude, and message goes as artists and creatives keep suffering. Nobody cares about your suffering. Nobody. You know what this is? This is the streamer entitlement syndrome. That's what this is. This is, you guys, you don't know how hard I have it as a streamer. I gotta sit on camera under these hot lights for 8 hours a day and stream video games and laugh and chat and have fun. You don't know the stress I have, what I have to deal with, dealing with all of these things that come my way, like emails, while that person who's watching that streamer is doing literal backbreaking labor. That's what this screams of. That is this crying right here. Nobody gives a fuck about how you feel. People just want to know that you can make good art. But at the same time, we're not throwing false accusations at Power World because you're mad or upset for whatever particular reason. So normalization of theft and plagiarism of this scale is unacceptable on so many levels. Do you have proof that they plagiarized, or are you just saying this because they're similar styles of art and character? I mean, there's no way that like a company like Nintendo would ever sit there and try to copy someone else's work and say, oh yeah, this is ours. And there's no way that Nintendo would have just been like, oh, why would we ever just put our game on a service where we can just take the ROM that we found on the internet and then put it on our service and provide it to you too, and then just go ahead and say, hey, yeah, you're just gonna keep the actual notations in the code from the actual ROM dump and just realize that everybody knows that you just went ahead and just took ROMs and put them on your... There's no way Nintendo would ever do that, right? There's no way that they would copy styles of artwork or just steal their own product and use that to sell it back to you. And then to make matters worse, he is in fact an illustrator and character designer. Yeah. It makes a lot of sense. The people who are actually angry about this thing are the ones that are scared about AI and AI artwork in the first place, instead of actually just embracing it, because there is no way around it. They're going to have to embrace it or they're going to fall off. So it's time to embrace it, my boy. And if you wouldn't believe it if I didn't show it to you live, Nintendo literally tweeted out the 21st, that's right, yesterday of the day of this recording. Did you catch that? Explore some hidden details within. I don't think there are any details here. There's literally zero. There's zero details. What details did we catch? And then prepare to get ratioed, outdone by an indie team because you insist on staying behind. It's just going to keep happening as long as you keep choosing to act like it's 2002. The whole world is playing Power World. Get ratioed, my boy. Is this game from 2003? Why would you tweet this now? Power World better. Every masterpiece has its cheap copy. Lil bro, we have some bad news. Y'all are finally getting collectively roasted for low-end effort, and I love to see it. Step it up. Power World is fire. LOL, I love Pokemon and grew up with it. That's why I say this. Step up your game. Power World is everything you should have done years ago and more. Still finding hidden details I couldn't tell with the graphics. Jeez. Oh my god, the cooking that is happening right now. But here's the thing about all of this. Is Power World using AI art? I don't know. I can't tell. Are they using stolen art pieces from Nintendo? I don't know. I'm not going to make that judgment call. It's not my place. It's whether or not they're going to admit it or whether or not this goes to court or what have you. The thing is this, though. I've shown that Nintendo has literally done the exact same thing that so many other people are in fact claiming Pal World has done with zero evidence, and they're running by it and sticking by it for whatever particular reason. There's no evidence that Pal World has used AI, and I'm going to give you a quick hot take on this. If they did use AI, what's the difference? What's the matter? Why would it be an issue? What does them using AI do to you? Literally nothing. You didn't work on the game, did you? No, you didn't. You didn't lose your job because of that game being developed with AI? No, you didn't. You're on Twitter using your moral grandstanding, your moral high horse, because you're angry that somebody else got their game out, got the idea done that you didn't have, that they are now being successful with. And let's not even go to the fact that at the same time of all this actually happening, the community manager of Pal World is going through as many DMs as he possibly can, and then also getting massive amounts of death threats. So, congratulations. Y'all are the scumbags. And that's my entire point of this. People are so angry and upset about a developer possibly using tools that can make game development easier because they didn't work as hard as you did or did what you have to do to get the same kind of recognition in the first place, or even more recognition, or turns out you're getting less recognition, which is really funny in my opinion. But this is merely nothing more than just main character syndrome, and I'm going to continue to call it out as such. I'm going to start playing Pal World tonight because I'm sure it's going to be quite an enjoyable experience, and I'll keep that going on. But the thing is this, if you're angry and upset that somebody else got to the base before you did, maybe you should step your game up instead. Instead of trying to sit there and be in the past and not use those tools that are available to you, you're the same kind of person trying to build a house with only a worn out hammer and a screwdriver that's a flathead when you need a Phillips. So instead of just complaining about someone else is using better tools, why don't you also get those same tools so you can build what you need to do better, faster, and more efficiently? That way you can put out the product that you know you can put out and be better about the game design that you want to do. But instead, you're going to sit here and bitch on Twitter because that's always easier, isn't it? Yeah, being a moral high horse and talking from your fucking ivory tower is a lot easier than getting down with your elbows in the dirt and getting to work. Everybody wants to be a bodybuilder, but nobody wants to lift no heavy ass weights. So ladies and gentlemen, if you liked today's video, thank you. If you didn't like it, fuck you. If you want to see more of this kind of content, subscribe to the channel. We're getting close to 61,000 subs, and I just want to say thank you guys very much. We are doing more gaming news, PC port reviews, Steam Deck videos, more fanboy content every Friday. At least I try to do it every Friday if anything happens on Thursday, but things happen, you know what I mean? Videos still come out though. Live streams every Saturday night at 8:45 p.m. Eastern. If you want to join the Discord and get emotes to those live streams, consider becoming a YouTube member. It's as low as $1. And I'm going to be real, y'all. If you don't want to spend the dollar, you don't have to. Just come on down to the live stream, hang out, have a good time, and watch as the chat berates me for 4.5 to 5 hours using TTS, calling me bald, a furry, and that I have a foot fetish. There's lots of memes there. You'll have a great time, trust me. With that being said, y'all, thank you guys so much for watching. Hope you have a great one, and I'll see you next time.